After last week's unfortunate intervention by Barry Windham, U.S. Heavyweight Champion Dustin Rhodes put his title on the line in a rematch with his friend and former teammate, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Z-Man and Johnny Gunn challenge world champion Big Van Vader and Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. And the unpredictable team of Cactus Jack and the Barbarian battle Texas troublemakers Tex Slasinger and Shanghai Pierce. Next on WCW Saturday Night.
Hello once again, everyone, and welcome to WCW Saturday Night. Jim Ross and Larry Zbyszko with you. And Larry, we are going to see, as the fans heard, that bizarre tag team combination of Cactus Jack and the Barbarian. Their popularity, surprisingly, is really rising.
You know, bizarre is a light term for these two guys. And like you said, I'm amazed myself. These people like these guys.
Fans will also tell you about the big Super Brawl 3 pay-per-view just about a month away on Sunday, February 21st. But we got some great action. Let's go up to the ring.
And the following tag team event, it is set for one fall. Team number one weighs in a combined weight of 494 pounds, Scotty Flamingo and Bob Cook. Ladies and gentlemen, our opponents weigh in a combined weight of 468 pounds, Marcus Alexander Bagwell and Johnny B. Penn.
From the Slam Jam 1 wrestling album brings Johnny B. Bad and the WCW Magazine Rookie of the Year Marcus Alexander Bagwell to the ring. Great crowd on hand here at center stage as referee Randy Anderson has called for the bell, and the veteran Bob Cook and Johnny B. Bad will start it out for their respective teams here on WCW Saturday Night. Waistlock go behind takedown by Johnny B. Bad.
Nice duck under by J.B. Bad. Very good speed. Johnny B. Bad, good athletic competitor here. Great physical shape, Jim.
Power and elbow tie up after the clean break. Bob Cook with the advantage into the wrist lock, but it's countered there by Johnny B. Bad. Fireman carry takeover. And Johnny B. Bad again, Larry, displaying his great speed and quickness for the arm drag takedown.
Yeah, and that was excellent timing on the part of JB right there. Timing is what makes the moves happen.
All right, right hand by Bob Cook. Johnny Bad again showing his agility. As Cook cradled and got a near fall there.
Well, he's been doing an excellent job of keeping Cook off his guard.
Double team offense by Bagwell and Johnny Bad. Another arm drag takeover. Bob Cook certainly being kept off balance here by this combination of Bagwell and Bad.
Yeah, they've got a tough competitor in their Cook, and they've kept him completely off guard by using their attributes: speed, science, agility, and of course teamwork. Tag in, tag out.
Marcus Alexander Bagwell, the nice slide headlock takeover. Competitive youngster from Sprayberry High School in nearby Marietta, Georgia. As we are coming to you from West Peachtree in Atlanta. Tag made. Kick to the midsection by Bagwell. Johnny B. Bad.
Oh!
High wrist move right off the top. And Scotty Flamingo interrupted the count and makes the tag now to Bob Cook. Flamingo, a tough competitor, front face locking Johnny B. Badd. And nice snap suplex, lateral press, and an air fall.
Very aggressive individual here, Flamingo. Good save, too. Boy, Johnny B. Badd did a beautiful sunset flip off the top. But the Flamingo saved the day here.
These two have had quite a rivalry in the last few months, as has been documented here. Oh, my! What an elbow!
Did you get the number of that elbow?
Man, that was tremendous impact. Knocking Flamingo all the way outside here. Flamingo crossed back up on the apron. And let's see if Johnny B. Badd now can take advantage. Well, he's not going to get the opportunity.
No, hey, smart move by Flamingo. Get the fresh man in. This is a tag team match.
Badd also tags in Bagwell. Wrist lock. And counter. Bob Cook with the drop toe, folks over, front face lock on Bagwell, but Bagwell quickly has countered Larry into the hammerlock. Bagwell's a very quick young man.
You know, very quick, and you got to give him credit. He's worked extremely hard, like you said, voted the Rookie of the Year, and that only comes through a lot of dedication and a lot of effort.
Bob Cook has Bagwell in trouble in the corner. Irish whip is reversed.
Oh,
what a right hand.
Good night, Bagwell.
Man, he nailed him with a right, and Bagwell is in big trouble here. Tag made. Let's see if Flamingo now can finish Bagwell off. What a right hand by Bob Cook. Bagwell made a counter and makes a tag. That was a smart move by Bagwell, Larry.
Yeah, that was very smart. Get Johnny B. Badd, get the fresh man in. You know, Flamingo, very aggressive. Oh!
Flamingo follows Johnny B. Badd in with a dominating clothesline. Snap mare into the reverse chin lock. And now the Flamingo foot combination seem to be building a little bit of momentum.
Well, they finally got one of these men where they want him on the mat. Boy, Badd fighting his way up.
Oh. Both men going for crossbody presses. They had the same idea. A mid-air collision here. Flamingo makes the tag, quick to the crook, and Badd tags in Bagwell. Bagwell sweeps up Bob Cook. Flamingo comes in. He slams for his trouble.
Well, Bagwell, Cook, they're the legal men. Referee's got to get Flamingo out of there.
Elbow off the second turnbuckle. And Flamingo stops the count again, but he's dropped, kicked right out of the ring by Johnny B. Badd. Nice move. He's got both arms up. One, two, three, go.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of this tag team match, Marcus Alexander Bagwell and Johnny B. Badd.
Fast-paced, serious match here, Jim. Look at that. Mid-air collision. But it was a teamwork right here, and a beautiful move by Bagwell as he backslided. Look, one, two, three.
Tony Schiavone standing by with a controversial Barry Windham.
Jim, you're right. Controversial certainly can be used to describe Barry Windham. It was 1 week ago right here on WCW Saturday Night. You were very instrumental in Dustin Rhodes becoming U.S. Heavyweight Champion.
What do you mean instrumental? The United States Heavyweight Championship is around Dustin Rhodes' waist right now. And he is an incredible champion, and he won it all by himself like he's always been capable of doing. Now, Ricky Steamboat, it wasn't over with you, but I'll guarantee you, we'll see each other down the road again.
Big announcement to make right now, fans. As you know, Super Brawl 3 comes your way on pay-per-view on Sunday, February 21st. And now it has been signed. The Great Muda will defend the NWA title against this man,
Barry. Listen, Schiavone, that was supposed to be mine. I'm supposed to tell everybody about this. Muda, the heavyweight championship is on the line, the NWA heavyweight championship. It's something that I've worked for my entire life and something I always wanted. This is going to be my day, and I'm going to leave that building with that championship around my waist, and Muda, you're going to go back to Japan a loser.
That from Barry Windham. More great action still to come on WCW Saturday Night. Stay with us. Ladies and gentlemen, to WCW Saturday Night. I'm here with Cowboy Bill Watts, the Vice President of Wrestling Operations for World Championship Wrestling. And Bill, this United States Heavyweight Championship situation certainly reached its peak last week. Dustin Rhodes won the title, but he didn't receive a belt.
Well, that's right. Rick Rude is not wanting to give the belt up. He's very upset about being stripped of the title. However, he may have the belt, but he is not the champion. Dustin Rhodes is the champion. Will eventually get the belt back from Rick Rude, and the only way he's going to get to keep it is if he comes back and wins it. We gave him 60 days that he didn't defend the title. It's unfortunate that he's injured. Without a doubt, I believe the injury. I've talked to his doctor, but he's not supposed to be back to March 1st. Dustin Rhodes is the U.S. champion.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, Dustin Rhodes certainly was upset the way he won the championship here last week. Let's go back 1 week and show you exactly how he became the U.S. champion. Dustin Rhodes was very upset when he saw the involvement of Barry Windham, and he wanted to go console his former partner, Ricky Steamboat.
Well, I understand he's concerned, but after all, you got to realize it's not his fault. It's something he had no control over, and he's still the champion. He didn't see what happened to Rick Steamboat, and we're just like the National Football League. We don't play a videotape replay and change a decision. Dustin Rhodes is champion, and there's no shadow on the title because it wasn't anything of his doing. So, I mean, I can understand how he feels. He wanted to give Ricky Steamboat another bout. We're going to do that. The main event tonight will be Ricky Steamboat versus Dustin Rhodes for the U.S. title. One fall or television time remaining. But we got a great series, a whole lot of new talent. Let's hook them up.
All right, Bill, thanks very much. We look forward to that rematch a little bit later in the program. But right now, let's go back up to our ring announcer, Tony Gillum. From Nevada at 309 pounds, Vinny Vega.
Strongest arm in WCW right now.
His opponent for this one-fall contest in the ring, 234 pounds, and hailing from St. Paul, Minnesota, Chad Bird.
Well, Larry, certainly obvious that Big Vinny Vega still has his sights set on a arm wrestling showdown with the strongest arm in WCW, Heavy Metal Van Hammer. We certainly wish Heavy Metal Van Hammer a speedy recovery from his injuries.
Yeah, because I want to see the arm wrestling contest. You know, Vinny Vegas, he's a lefty, so he wants to do it barroom style.
Big Vinny Vegas, a seven-footer. 309 pounds, obviously a very strong, very physical competitor. And here's another big guy.
Oh,
man, high impact move.
has a lot of agility, a lot of natural athletic ability for a 7-foot man.
Yeah, for a man his size, a very aggressive individual, very strong. Man. And he's learning how to use that height advantage as a weapon. And that's a big weapon.
Vegas drives the elbow down on young Chad Bird here. Bird may be soon flying away if Vegas has his way with things. Dynamite right hand. This guy can brawl with you, but he has certainly refined many of his wrestling skills. And oh, it may be time.
He's going for snake eyes.
I think you got it. Bird just driven into the top turnbuckle, and this one is over.
The winner of the match, Vinny Vega.
Blow on those dice, Vinny. You know, Jim, here we have it. Vinny Vega's using that great height advantage from 7 feet through those dice. Bam! Chad Bird, unfortunately, Bird, wrapped out.
Chris Benoit is next on WCW Saturday night.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is set for one fall. From Edmonton, Alberta, 225 pounds, Chris Benoit. His opponent in the ring, 235 pounds, from Montgomery, Alabama, Johnny Rich.
Welcome back, everyone, to WCW Saturday Night. Referee Mike Atkins has called for the bell. Jim Ross and Larry Zbyszko back with you. And Larry, this should be an outstanding contest. The international star, Chris Benoit, is one of the finest competitors ever to come out of the southern part of the United States, Johnny Rich.
And Johnny Rich, experienced veteran here. Definite veteran. Benoit's cab if he can beat him.
Front face lock. And it's countered very quickly by Rich. And both men up to a vertical base. Benoit, who was trained by Calgary wrestling promoter Stu Hart, also the father of some outstanding athletes himself. And Hart trained Benoit. Benoit, the last 4 years or so, been in Japan competing. Nice takedown by Johnny Rich, but we certainly can't discount the abilities, as we said, of Johnny Rich. He has had many regional championships. Headlock. Rich in control here. Benoit shows his, oh my, this agility, and what a martial arts kick by Chris Benoit. Benoit is all business, Larry.
Yeah, all business, and he sure cracked Johnny Rich in the back of the head. Rich had no idea what was coming. Oh!
Connected to that clothesline.
A very, very agile individual, as you watch the movement of Chris Benoit. But the man's whole body is a potential weapon.
Benoit kicking Johnny Rich in the ribs and the abdomen. And now scoops him up, trying to dry the oxygen right out of Rich. Lateral press, and the ever-tough Johnny Rich able to kick out before the fatal three count. Side. Thought it was going to be a side slam, Larry, but he got the backbreaker in.
Yeah, backbreaker. Look at the pressure he's putting on the lower back of Rich by pushing down on the chin and down on the leg. Yeah, he's knocked the wind out of Rich earlier, being very aggressive. He's keeping it up. He knows he's on top now, and that's where Benoit's going to stay.
And then the slam by Chris Benoit. And boom! The second rope, high risk move that did connect. He drove his thigh right in the face of Johnny Rich. Front face lock again by Benoit, and snaps it off into the suplex. Again, the lateral press. He could have him here, and Johnny Rich still fighting, still competing, able to get the right shoulder up.
In fact, all the movement is being directed at that lower back and knocking the wind out of Rich.
Benoit trying to get him down, but Johnny Rich made a great counter move. Fall away slam, driving the air out of Chris Benoit. And now it's Johnny Rich's opportunity to widen an advantage here, to gain more specifically an offensive advantage. He catches Benoit with the right hand. Johnny Rich, the drop kick. Benoit now in trouble as Rich gets the lateral pass and a near fall. Johnny Rich won away from defeating Chris Benoit here on TBS.
That was close, and Benoit powered up. Great shape. Good.
Johnny Rich caught him in a power slam. This should be it. One, two, and Benoit shows his pugnacious athletic abilities by kicking out before the three. Benoit has got him in a full Nelson. Back into the German suplex with a bridge, and Benoit wins it.
Here is your winner, Chris Benoit.
Jim, excellent, excellent wrestler here, Chris Benoit. And that was no lightweight in there. He's a veteran, Johnny Rich. Look at this beautiful move right across the face of Rich. I don't think Rich knew where he was.
Fans, our wrestling hotline talks about names like this.
The Super Brawl 3 Control Center. Super Brawl 3 comes your way exclusively on pay-per-view on Sunday, February 21st from beautiful Asheville, North Carolina. Big Van Vader, the heavyweight champion of the world, will go one-on-one with Sting. We don't know the stipulations to that match as of yet, but we'd like to show you the invitation issued by Big Van Vader, the acceptance by Sting at the recent Clash of the Champions, and then the last time these two got together.
The wrestling world is eagerly anticipating the upcoming one-on-one battle between WCW World's Heavyweight Champion Big Van Vader and the incomparable Sting at Super Brawl 3. The 450-pounder from the Rocky Mountains recently issued this very unique invitation to the Stinger.
February 21st, we have a date with destiny. Super Brawl 3, the game becomes reality.
Vader's invitation to his unknown White Castle of Fear was quickly accepted by WCW's most popular athlete.
I never, ever, one time walked away from it, and Van Vader, I'm not going to walk away from your Castle of Fear.
Once again, Sting will venture into the unknown, this time to face WCW's most powerful competitor. Wrestling fans worldwide are looking forward to another classic battle between the sport's two top superstars.
We hope to have more information on the Sting-Big Van Vader matchup at Super Brawl right here next week in the Super Brawl 3 Control Center. Another match that has been signed will be for the NWA Heavyweight Championship. The new title holder, the Great Muta, will take on the controversial Barry Windham at Super Brawl 3. Here's a look at that tremendous matchup for the NWA title.
WCW officials are excited to announce the signing of the NWA Championship bout between the new title holder, the Great Muta, and WCW superstar Barry Windham. The spectacular Muta recently defeated Masachono in the Tokyo Dome before over 60,000 fans to win the coveted NWA title.
Once again.
This will be Muta's first NWA title defense in the United States and will also be a rematch between the final two men in the recent battle for competition at Starrcade 92.
Muta, hold on! He's still in it! Down goes Windham! Another dropkick!
The Great Muta's NWA title defense versus Barry Windham will definitely be one of the most outstanding bouts at this year's Super Brawl 3 pay-per-view.
That is going to be a tremendous wrestling match. The Great Muta and Barry Windham for the NWA title, and another match sign. The Smoky Mountain Tag Team Champions, the Rock and Roll Express, will meet the Wrecking Crew. Here's a look.
When the Smoky Mountain Wrestling Tag Team Champions, the Rock and Roll Express, face WCW's newest team, the Wrecking Crew, it'll mark the first time that tag champions from another United States wrestling organization have competed at a WCW pay-per-view event. Let's take a look at Ricky Morton and Robert Gibson, the legendary Rock and Roll Express, in action against their longtime nemesis, Jim Coronet and the Midnight Express from 1990.
Referee's calling for the bell.
Yes, sir.
They elevate. Beautiful Bobby. Double team, sweet stand. The match is over. We haven't heard the bell. We haven't heard the bell.
There it is.
This tag team bout between Smoky Mountain Wrestling's Rock and Roll Express and WCW's Wrecking Crew will definitely be one of the many highlights at next month's pay-per-view spectacular from Asheville, North Carolina.
We certainly look forward to seeing the Smoky Mountain Tag Team Champions of Rock and Roll Express in action. They'll be in Asheville, North Carolina on Sunday, February 21st. Plus, next week, we hope to have the matchup involving Sting and Big Van Vader finalized. What type of stipulations will they have in that matchup? We hope to tell you right here next week. Plus, the great Moot and Barry Windham for the NWA title. It's going to be a tremendous event. The only way to see it is exclusively on pay-per-view by calling your local cable company. Super Brawl 3 comes your way February 21st. Welcome back, everyone, to WCW Saturday Night. We've been keeping you updated on the Rock and Roll Express. As you know, they will be a part of Super Brawl 3 exclusively on pay-per-view on Sunday, February 21st. Larry, they're going to take on the Wrecking Crew, and Ricky Morton and Robert Gibson will be right here next week in person to scout their opponent, the Wrecking Crew, who we're going to see in a few moments. This is a great combination.
Yeah, it's going to be an interesting matchup, too. You know, the Wrecking Crew, if they should defeat a Rock and Roll Express, which is almost becoming a legendary team in the sport, would be a real big feather in their caps.
The Rock and Roll Express, the current Smoky Mountain Wrestling Tag Team Champions, made some comments earlier this week. Here they are.
You know, it's been a bumpy track for the Rock and Roll Express, but as you can see, we're back together, and we've got the gold.
You know, it seems like the more things change, the more the things stay the same. You see, I'm not the same man I used to be when I wrestled for WCW. But one thing that does remain the same, the team that we took these belts from is managed by Jimmy Cornette. And I'd like to say hi to all the nice fans out there over the Superstation that have seen us in some of our greatest victories. And that's another thing to be a pleasure, to be the first wrestling champions from another promotion to ever appear on Super Brawl pay-per-view, February the 21st, baby, because rock and roll is here to stay. Things are the same. We're still the champions, and we'll see you at Super Brawl February the 21st.
Wrestling fans, the following tag team event, it is set for one fall from Detroit, Michigan. Weighing in a total combined weight of 550 pounds, Rage and Fury, the Wrecking Crew. Entering their opponents, weighing in a combined weight of 510 pounds, the Italian Stallion and Larry Santo.
Yeah, I'd like to take a second here, Jim, to wish the best of luck to our new commander-in-chief, Hillary Clinton.
I got that wrong, did it? The commander-in-chief is Bill Clinton.
Right? I have it right.
All right, referee Randy Anderson has called for the bell. That's Rage of the Wrecking Crew. And it will be Fury starting it out for the Wrecking Crew against the former AAU champion, the Italian Stallion. And we certainly are excited about the Smoky Mountain Champions. Rock and Roll Express being a part of Super Brawl as Fury forces the Stallion back into the corner.
These guys locked up like two bulls, and they are both big, strong men. The Stallion, no slouch in there. He knows the moves, Jim.
Oof. Here they impact these two athletes. This time it's the Stallion with the advantage, forcing Fury of the Wrecking Crew back into the corner.
Now Fury's definitely in there with somebody his own size.
Great crowd on hand here at center stage. And again, these two athletes lock up. It's the Stallion.
Oh!
Stallion had the advantage. But boy, only for a few moments as Fury landed that clothesline. And now the football blocks into the midsection. Irish whip. Nobody there. Barry Santo receives attack from the Italian Stallion. Santo's offensive advantage is rather short-lived as Rage has been tagged in.
Well, this is the problem I think they're going to have here. I think the Wrecking Crew way far ahead on teamwork. The amount of time they spent together. Teamwork, that's the name of the game here in tag team wrestling.
Oh! Wow, Frank from the Rage. Santo able to make the tag now for the Italian Stallion.
Teamwork I'm talking about.
Power slam. Wrecking Crew back in control of this tag team event. Man, powerful short clothesline. They have a variety of high impact, hard hitting offensive maneuvers they like to utilize. Sledgehammer right to the spine.
Man,
Fury muscled him up.
Really pure power there. Both these men, very powerful individuals, and they had that tag team down. That's why the Stallion is in the position he's in.
Now, Stallion's got an outstanding amateur wrestling background, but has been unable to get on track in this one thus far. Got to hand it to this new team of the Wrecking Crew. We're keeping the burner turned up, so to speak. And the Stallion there.
He tagged.
Got a tag. That's what he needed to do. Barry Santo. Right against it. Offensive advantage here. Drop kick. Went for it again, but Fury was well aware of, or just stepped away, knocked it down, and the tag is mid-made.
Well, Santos is just getting out of this one.
They call that the wrecking ball. And it's over.
The winners of this tag team event, Rage and Fury, the Wrecking Crew.
This powerful combination who will meet Rock and Roll Express at Super Bowl on pay-per-view. We'll be talking momentarily to Larry Zbyszko.
Yeah, thanks, Jim. We're going to talk to the Wrecking Crew. Now, obviously, you guys have got one thing on your mind. What is it, baby?
Mr. Larry Zbyszko! There was once a great team in TBS, and that was the Minnesota Wrecking Crew. That was then. We are now. Look at the new Wrecking Crew, Rage and Fury. The Wrecking Crew is here for one reason, to beat Ricky Steamboat and Shane Douglas and become the next unified tag team champions. Tex Schlesinger, Pierce, it doesn't matter. Austin Pillman, it doesn't matter. The only thing that matters is that we will be the next tag team champions. Fear the Rage. Feel the Fury. No prisoners. No mercy.
We'll be right back after this.
This is Tony Schiavone coming to you from Milwaukee, and what a battle it was for the Unified World Tag Team Championship. Gentlemen, you're still the champs, but it was quite a war.
You know something, Tony Schiavone? The announcers, wrestling editors on magazines, they kept saying that Shane Douglas was the weakest link in this tag team combination. They kept saying that this tag team is not vicious enough. Well, it all started with this, the gold. The World Heavyweight Championship Tag Team Unified. You can't get any higher than this.
Yes, a war has just been started.
A war?
And you know,
a war? If this is a war, we'll fly on Brian and Stunning Steve. You drew first blood. My dad always said, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. You gentlemen decided to start the war in blood. You can make darn sure and place the bet. We are happy to finish it anytime, any place you gentlemen want.
right here on TBS, you're going to get an opportunity to see what two real men are all about. Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff, and the big man himself, Big Van Vader, Tom Zink, and Johnny Gunn. This is coming after you.
You know something, Zink and Gunn? I can tell you this right now, that one of you or both of you are going to get hurt. And I mean hurt. Two guys have played in the NFL.
Tell him, Paul. Tell him. Tell him, brother.
Two guys aren't afraid of nothing. And as far as for you, Cactus Jack, Mr. Wonderful hasn't forgotten that shovel. Nobody, and I mean nobody, hits Mr. Wonderful and gets away with it. The fact of the matter is, I beat you fair and square, and you weren't mad enough.
Tell him, Paul. Tell him. Stinger, are you listening? Are you looking? Cactus Jack, are you listening? I'm listening. Who's talking at you? The pain and agony of Mr. Wonderful and Big Van Vader is coming at you. And I want every wrestler in the WCW to take notice. Stand up, look, and listen. Because we're here, and we're staring right at you. And Tom Zink and Johnny Gunn, you two pretty boys. I used to steal lunch money from punks like you in high school. And Paul, I haven't powerbombed anybody all day long.
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, this tag team event is set for one fall on WCW Saturday night. Introducing first team number one. They weigh in a combined weight of 490 pounds. The Z-Man and Johnny Gunn.
Jim Ross and Larry Zbyszko back with you here at center stage. The popular combination of the Z-Man and Johnny Gunn making their way to the ring. Fans still to come here on the program. Tony Schiavone goes up close with the Stinger, plus the big rematch for the United States heavyweight title. Ricky Steamboat and Dustin Rhodes, the new champion, right here today on TBS.
Ladies and gentlemen, their opponents weigh in at a combined weight of 702 pounds and are accompanied to the ring by seven-time world heavyweight champion Harley Race. Introducing first, Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff. His tag team partner is the heavyweight champion of the world, Big Van Vader.
And you know, Jim, when Harley Race says here's two of the last real men, he's not kidding.
Well, they are as bad as they come, especially that big monster. We hope to find out next week the specifics on Vader's one-on-one matchup with Sting at Super Brawl 3 in the White Castle of Fear situation. We'll know hopefully more about that right here next week. But one thing we do know for sure, that just around the corner, it will be Vader and Sting for the heavyweight championship of the world. And Larry, that's one match that I will not miss.
And I'm going to be at ringside right next to you.
Big Van Vader.
Talking about the matchup here, this could be the day when the Z-Man and Johnny Gunn won't be looking so pretty.
Well, it's also a great opportunity for this young team to really assert themselves deeply in the tag team picture against a great team of Orndorff and Vader. Fireman Carey takeover by Mr. Wonderful and quickly countered into the head scissors. Both these athletes are very, very quick.
Z-Man. Side headlock with the advantage. Nice shoulder lock. Using the ropes for some momentum. Orndorff shows his agility. And Z-Man caught him with a martial arts kick. Lateral press. He's going for the cover. And a near fall here in the early going by Tom Zink, better known as the Z-Man.
Yeah, and Paul Orndorff, just one of the power out of that. Extremely well-conditioned athlete. This is the type of guy, he runs across the mountaintops carrying elk, Jim. Real outdoorsman.
Z-Man makes a tag with Johnny Gunn. And Johnny Gunn hammering away at the arm of Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. And if their game plan is to keep Orndorff in the ring and isolate Big Van Vader on the outside, I think that's very sound.
And that would make sense to me. You don't want Van Vader in the ring. You know, try to keep Mr. Wonderful there. At least you're talking the same size.
Orndorff with a knee lift. And using the hair, driving Johnny Gunn to the corner, and here comes the monster, the 450-pound heavyweight champion of the world.
Oh, oh my!
His forearms look like oak tree limbs, hammering away at the head of Johnny Gunn, the headbutt right to the youngster from Philadelphia's face. Vader is so physical, so devastating.
He's just clubbing him into the twilight zone. Oh. This is what Johnny Gunn and Z-Man don't want to contend with. Van Vader in the ring.
Johnny Gunn able to move out of Vader's way, and Quigley only got a one count there. Oh! Johnny Gunn, even though he got some momentum, still couldn't put the big man down. He dropped out of sight. He avoided Vader, who went right over the top rope out here to the concrete floor right in front of us.
And here comes Gunn!
Johnny Gunn! Throws Gunn back in the ring.
Boy, Gunn just snapped. He flew out there and just tackled Vader in midair.
Vader was always in control. However, he may have got caught over the top rope, but this big man is so massive and so strong, he makes the tag to Mr. Wonderful. And he throws the drop kick right into the face of Johnny Gunn.
Well, Van Vader is convinced he feels no pain, and I believe him.
Face off. That's the double-back suplex. A district crowd here at center stage, standing tall in the direction of Mr. Wonderful.
That's not going to affect Mr. Wonderful. Very impressive, very tenacious, great competitor, tag.
T-Man, oh, look for the corner. Orndorff putting it out of the way. There's a suplex. T-Man in trouble now. And here's the tag.
The T-Man is in trouble now.
Big Van Vader now. Great right hand. Look at the impact. Those right hands. Right face stop. And he twisted him. He twisted the Z-Man in midair and grilled him with a suplex.
Yeah, that's a real nasty maneuver. Twisted his body, but holding on to his neck. Do you know what that does?
The raw power of the heavyweight champion of the world. He is sitting on top of the mountain right now. Can any human being unseat this monster for the heavyweight championship of the world? Out here chanting for the Z-Man to get back into it. Z-Man attempted sunset flip there, but Orndorff blocked and caught Z-Man with a fist right to the face. Crossfire to Z-Man. Just as Orndorff has got a two count. Comic Rock and Orndorff quickly backs in Big Van Vader. Z-Man saved himself there and gets a tag in with Johnny Gunn. Johnny Gunn is hitting Vader with all he's got and just drops the world champion. He knocks down Orndorff, but he can't get Vader off his feet. Z-Man there on Orndorff. Chaotic here. Orndorff being knocked outside.
Vader and legal men, Vader and Johnny Gunn.
Oh, Vader in firm control here. He said he had powerbombed anybody all day. Waist lock. I drilled him. He drilled him with a powerbomb. And it's over. And Orndorff on the outside. He powerbombed Z-Man. Combination.
Austin. Look at Van Vader wanted that powerbomb fix. Bam! He got one at the expense of Johnny Gunn. And these guys, Jim, they're not getting any prettier.
Vader with a big lateral press. Vance still to come. There you see Orndorff. He drilled him with that power driver. Sting and WCW up closes just around the corner.
All right, I'm very happy to be sitting beside the man they call the franchise in World Championship Wrestling, certainly the most dramatic figure in all of sports, former World Heavyweight Champion Sting. Sting, thanks a lot for your time. As we take a look back of last year, 1992, a lot of great moments, a lot of great matches I know for you, but first of all, I want to touch on maybe a memory that's not too pleasant for you, but certainly was a big night, the Great American Bash. Pay-per-view, Sting and Big Van Vader for the WCW World Heavyweight title. You came in as World Heavyweight Champion, going up against a man at 450 pounds. It was a tremendous night. Pay-per-view audience all over the world watched it. One of the best matches of 1992. As you take a look back at that night, what are some of your thoughts?
If I had to say it in one word, I'd say physical, definitely physical. 450 pounds, Van Vader, the biggest, strongest man I've ever been in the ring against. And to this day, I don't think there's anyone that has ever equaled him. Maybe nobody ever will. And I went into that match with a certain strategy, and that strategy was take this 250-pound body and try and outlast him and try and get him huffing and puffing at 450 pounds. And once I got him to that point, maybe take advantage of him. But, you know, in the heat of the battle, I made a mistake, maybe because I was huffing and puffing. Right. Maybe I mistook his wind. Mm-hmm. And he's got a big back, had him up against a turnbuckle, sweaty in the heat of the battle, and I overshot him in a Stinger splash and literally slid off his back. Collided head first with the steel turnbuckle, and I think that was a turning point, and I think that he took advantage of that. He hooked me up and gave me that power bomb, and I could never describe the way that felt, but I can tell you this, I don't care who you are, if you're the $6 million man, no human being on the face of this earth is ever going to kick out of that move.
Well, he's injured quite a few wrestlers with that power bomb as well. Now we
That's
take
right.
you to Starrcade, certainly one of the biggest nights of your entire career. At the beginning of Starrcade on December 28th, you received the Battle Bowl ring from winning Battle Bowl the year before. You went on to participate in a Lethal Lottery tag match. You went on, of course, to participate in Battle Bowl as well, but you also had the King of Cable, first ever King of Cable championship against the same guy, Big Van Vader. And what a tremendous night that was. I want to ask you, comparing that to the Great American Bash, did you have any different strategy? You'd already wrestled him in the Great American Bash for the world title. Had you changed your strategy in December at Starrcade?
No, actually no. I went in with the same exact strategy, try to wear this guy out. And basically, I think that's exactly what I did, especially at one point there where he had me locked up in the corner, and all I could do was put my hands up like this while he was swinging those big clubs of his back and forth, and I could hear him breathing. I could hear him puffing and puffing, and I kept literally asking him to come on and keep firing, and he did, and I think it worked for me because that was a turning point. I felt his wind start to go, and I felt it was my time to make my move and pounce, and that's exactly what I did, and it paid off for me.
Well, certainly gives you a lot of momentum going into 1993. The new year is upon us, and everyone is talking about Super Brawl 3 on pay-per-view on Sunday, February 21st. And I know Super Brawl has a special meaning for you because last year you became World Heavyweight Champion of Super Brawl, and I know you'll never forget that. But
right.
But let's talk about the Super Brawl that's upon us. There's been an invitation from Big Van Vader. We know it's going to be you and Vader one-on-one at Super Brawl. He has handed out an invitation for you to come to the White Castle of Fear. What do you know about the White Castle of Fear?
Tony, I don't know anything about the White Castle of Fear, and I didn't know anything about spin the wheel, make the deal. I walked right down into the Devil's Den with Jake the Snake, into his little world there, and I played his little game. It didn't pay off too good for Jake the Snake, though. So now the second time around, Big Van Vader, he wants to invite me to the White Castle of Fear, whatever it is. I don't care what it is. Let me tell you something, Vader. It doesn't matter what it is. I'm just glad to have the opportunity to get back in the ring with you, the World Heavyweight Champion. Maybe one of these days I'll regain that title again. I don't ever, ever run away from an invitation, and I don't ever, ever run away from a challenge, even if it comes from you. So I'll see you, my friend, at Super Brawl, and I'll see you at the White Castle of Fear, because I like a party, and also, I never walk away from anything.
Sting on WCW Up Close.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match is set for one fall. Introducing first, 242 pounds, and hailing from Denver, Colorado,
Lands on his feet. That'll be a suplex. Scorpio now. trying to gain the offensive momentum. Irish whip, left to right, and Wyndham elevated, and the back body drop. It's Scorpio with a drop kick to the face. And he caught Wyndham with a bit forearm. Lateral press, and Wyndham able to kick out.
Scorpio's going to have to get real aggressive here like that. Wyndham, he's way ahead on points here.
Near fall after that super kick to the face. Scorpio got yet another near fall on Barry Wyndham and scoops up the big man from Sweetwater, Texas, and slams him. Scorpio, oh, what a move there. Trying to hook the leg. Wyndham too strong for that penny prediction.
Yes, Scorpio's going to have to stick to his game plan. He's going to have to improve his speed. There you go.
Scorpio. Outside. Oh, no, Wyndham had that man cross-counted, obviously. Able to move out of the way. Scorpio took a chance, and Wyndham with a sledgehammer like blow right off the top rope. And here he comes, the front face lock. He calls that move the implant, and he implants his opponent's head right into the canvas. It's over.
The winner of the match, Barry Wyndham.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Barry Wyndham. Indeed, on the collision course for the new U.S. champion, Dustin Rhodes, but he will meet the great Muta on February 21st at Super Brawl 3. Scorpio took a chance offensively, and this time it did not pay off. Here you see the front face lock. Wyndham calls it his implant. Fans Larry Zbysko is standing by with the Bazaar, Texas Jack. The Barbarian, let's go down to Larry and jump it in.
Thanks, Jim. You know, let's just skip the formalities, Cactus. I know how you feel about Paul Orndorff and Van Vader. No disqualification, and that's your cup of tea.
No disqualification. The way the wrestling was meant to be, will it be the end? I doubt it. You see, Cactus Jack and the Barbarian have come equipped for the long haul. You see, Van Vader, as long as the ribs of mine that you splashed keep me awake at night, this thing ain't over. Paul Orndorff, as long as the neck that you pile drove snaps, crackles, and pops like a bowl of sadistic Rice Krispies, then I know that this thing ain't over. And as long as there is an ounce of blood flowing into this twisted mind, then I guarantee you, Larry Zbysko, this thing is far from over. Got the Barbarian on my side. We're going for war. So, Mr. Wonderful, if you hear a bang bang on your door, and you look outside, and it's Cactus Jack and the Barbarian asking if you want to come outside and play, then realize that you made the mistake of your life. A few short moments, we walk out here, the Barbarian and I, against Tex Schlesinger and Shanghai Pierce, two ugly, smelly scallywags, trying to remind me of a young Cactus Jack. But whether you bear resemblance to me or not, you're gonna learn that you take a bite out of Cactus Jack, the taste will make you sick. Bang, bang!
Wrestling fans, the following challenge tag team event is set for one fall. Team number one weighs in at a combined weight of 622 pounds. Tex Schlesinger and Shanghai Pierce.
Welcome back, everyone, to WCW Saturday Night. Schlesinger and Pierce make their way to the ring. Remember, still to come, the rematch for the United States Heavyweight title. Rhodes and Steamboat still to come here on WCW Saturday Night. Back up to Tony Gillum.
Their opponents win at a combined weight of 607 pounds. Cactus Jack and the Barbarian.
Cactus Jack and the Barbarian. Popularity certainly evident here today at center stage. Yeah, quite a matchup. this morning on the Power Hour are Vic Van Vader and Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. Referee Nick Patrick assigned this contest. As we remind our friends in the Atlanta area, we'll be right back here at center stage this Monday night, 7 o'clock, for another national television taping. And the bell sounds, and we're ready to go here. And it will be Shanghai Pierce picking it off for his squad, and Cacti for his field.
You're going to have to feel sorry for Nick Patrick in this match, because being a referee involved with these four men is going to be one job, I tell you.
Tex Schlesinger has quite a fan club, apparently, here at center stage today. Darnell bow tie up. It's Shanghai Pierce forcing the 300-pound Texas Jack back into the corner. Oh, right hand. Texas Jack, high impact elbow right to the chest, and down goes Pierce. Texas Jack drops at 300 plus right across Shanghai. And Mr. Bang Bang, he's the legion of fans is certainly growing, as we mentioned.
Well, it's wild in here. They both have legions of fans. I can't figure that out. Oh, here they go outside the ring.
Texas Cactus hooking it up here on the apron. A real fist fight has ensued here. And Cactus with a headbutt. Cactus Jack tosses Tex out here on the floor. Oh, Cactus measures him, and Tex low falls out of elbow range.
Yeah, Tex Schlesinger knows the reputation of Cactus. Cactus will literally throw himself into cement or anybody. He is a nut. That's why Tex Schlesinger was slithering for his life.
Cactus Jack makes the tag to the powerful Barbarian.
There's a man you don't want to meet in a dark alley.
Schlesinger with that elbow and the knee to the midsection. Big raw bone youngster. And he's elevated by the Barbarian. Barbarian, as Larry Zbysko mentioned, a dangerous athlete, to say the least. Front face lock. He gets Big Tex Schlesinger up and over in the suplex.
And that's a lot of power. Tex Schlesinger, he's a big guy. Barbarian, for his mass, he can move. He's very agile.
The Barbarian tags him, Cactus Jack. Cactus Jack obviously has a big score to settle with Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff, and likewise. And there you see Cactus signaling the Barbarian, and he rams Texas head right into the head of the Barbarian, and Schlesinger's just about out on his feet.
Well, the Barbarian is a weapon from head to toe. The interesting point here is, what kind of tag team strategy are you going to use against the Barbarian and Cactus Jack?
Well, Schlesinger able to make the tag to Shanghai Pierce. Pierce counters the Barbarian into that wrist lock, but not for long. Hard right hand. Man, this Shanghai Pierce is really a tough customer.
They're tough customers. I'm trying to figure out their game plan now. Just quick tag in and out.
Double clothesline by the Barbarian. Man, that sounded like a demolition derby there.
So much for the well laid out plans of men.
Boy, there's nothing pretty about this. It is a brutal situation here. And, well, this time, Slashes are able to avoid that kick to the back of the head. Luckily for him, and he makes a tag to his masked partner, Shanghai Pierce, lateral press. And the Barbarian, too strong, powered out of two.
Very strong. What are you doing? That's why Shane out here. Headlock. Basic move.
Man. Power slam. Tag made. Cactus Jack back in. And so is Tex. And Tex and Cactus resume their railing fist fight here. And slashes and rakes the eyes of Cactus. Oh, kicked him right in the heart. He's got him hooked up here. Cactus avoiding the masked man and drops Tex right on his head and face. Cactus Jack hooks the leg, and it is over. Cactus Jack and Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff have a date with destiny somewhere down the road. But I'm sure the Barbarian, as would every athlete in WCW, would love to meet Big Van Vader one-on-one. But this was an impressive tag team victory.
Yeah, it was an impressive man, the Barbarian. Look at the raw power of this very agile. Cactus Jack basically ducked out of the way, Shanghai tried to no avail, and there goes the cacti. Bam! Right in the head.
Fans, we talk about some of the biggest names in wrestling on the wrestling hotline until midnight tonight. And our main event for the U.S. title is still to come on TBS.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is set for one fall or TV time remaining. It is for the WCW United States Heavyweight title. Introducing first the challenger, 241 pounds, from Charlotte, North Carolina, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
Welcome back, everyone, to WCW Saturday Night. Jim Ross and Larry Zbyszko back with you. Quick reminder, next week during the broadcast, it has been signed. Sting and Dustin Rhodes next week will meet Big Van Vader and Barry Windham right here on the broadcast at 6:05 Eastern Time. And Gordon Soley will be Tony Schiavone's guest in up close.
Ladies and gentlemen, his opponent from Austin, Texas, 263 pounds. He's the newly crowned United States Heavyweight Champion, the natural, Dustin Rhodes.
Dustin Rhodes making his way to the ring. And as you heard earlier, Ravishing Rick Rude has failed to return the United States Heavyweight Championship belt to WCW. But Rhodes, no mistaking about it, is the U.S. Heavyweight Champion. He hated the way he won the title last week due to Wyndham's interference. And the rematch is signed. This one should be a very spirited yet competitive rematch.
Should be very competitive, especially after what we saw last week. Both these men hard fight to the end, which of course you want to win, but you can't blame Dustin Rhodes for not wanting to win it that way. You can't feel self-gratified with that turn of events.
Barry Windham had a unique way of ruining both Steamboat and Windham's day here last week. Nice shoulder block by the United States Heavyweight Champion, comes to the near side. Good quick counter move there by Rhodes. And Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, one half of the Unified World Tag Team Champions. And I'll tell you, as you look at the natural,
look at the intensity in the eyes of Dustin Rhodes. You know, after their match last week, it's going to be interesting to see who changed their strategy and how they changed it.
Side headlock takeover by Rhodes. Steamboat counters into the head scissor. Rhodes going right back to that headlock, and Steamboat not staying in that predicament very long. This match, one fall or television time remaining for the United States Heavyweight Championship.
Well, he's got a figure four on the head and that arm bar. Steamboat's strategy seems to be almost like last week, keep Dustin Rhodes on the mat. Dustin Rhodes, bigger man, has a height advantage. On the mat, everybody's equal.
Rhodes able to free himself and now focus on the legs of Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Steamboat, as we pointed out here last week in this contest, very quick has a speed advantage over Rhodes. I'm not saying Rhodes is slow, but Steamboat is really sudden, and this is good strategy for the natural.
Really plugging the pressure. That might have been a mistake there.
Steamboat able to counter to the hammerlock. Steamboat, that wealth of experience. Hooking an arm now.
Trying to get that half Nelson in and turn Dustin over on his shoulders, and there he goes.
Can he predict him out of 2 pounds? Again, Steamboat forcing Rhodes into that pinning predicament. These two men at one time were the World Tag Team Champions. They still are good pals.
Yeah, tell me about it.
You know much better than I. Got headlock takeover. Other side headlock. And Steamboat counters again. Steamboat quickly countering Rhodes. And that may be the biggest change in the strategy from last week until this Saturday.
Well, I think what they're going to have to incorporate is the use of a lot more combinations. One move is not enough. You need combinations. We got one heck of a chess match going on here, Jim.
Sure do. A lot of fans have community comments to make about this U.S. title situation last Sunday on my radio program on AM 750 WSB. And almost to the man and to the woman, they were very irate at Barry Windham. Test of strength here.
Yeah, this is really, I don't think, the Steamboat's advantage. Using up a lot of energy on a test of strength, which really isn't the issue here. Steamboat's got to wrestle.
Rhodes at 6'6". Big leverage advantage, but look at Steamboat. Oh, great technique.
Good move.
Great technique by Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. You know, Steamboat and Shane Douglas, the Unified Tag Champions, has such a war right now with Flying Brian Pillman and Stunning Steve Austin. We heard the comments during the program that the champions made right after the Clash of the Champions. That one is so volatile, to say the least, as Steamboat forces Rhodes back to the ropes. Clean break.
Whoa.
Rhodes trying to counter, and it hooked from outside.
It was a double counter.
Okay, very aggressive here. And stakes, as you know.
I can't hear what they're saying.
The stakes so high, and the tippers are...
Look at the idea of what they've been saying.
The tippers are reaching a boiling point here.
Yeah, there's a lot of frustration in this match already after what happened last week. Dustin Rhodes, of course, wants to feel the gratification of finally earning a championship after all the hard time and effort he's put in. Of course, Steamboat has to feel the exact same way, being robbed at the hands of Barry Windham, maybe.
These men both very physically vying for position here on the ropes, and Rhodes has forced Steamboat back in the corner. Referee Mike Atkins trying to go between the men and trying to wedge his way between them, and he does. Good officiating. Well, both these men, obviously.
Oh!
Nice! Steamboat slapping, and Rhodes slapped Steamboat back.
They're losing it!
Oh, the drop kick! And there goes Steamboat! I can't believe the exchange we've just seen here. Oh, tremendous martial arts chop by Steamboat. Oh, yeah.
Boy, this has the potential of a downy booker if I've ever seen one. Look at the eyes in this. And these men are getting redder and redder, brother.
Well, when you're wrestling for a championship as prestigious as the United States heavyweight title, you can expect an emotional situation between great athletes.
But this is somewhat surprising, as far as I'm concerned. Steamboat scoops up Rhodes and slams him with authority. Got him up there again. Steamboat. Worked with a big splash. Rhodes able to make an adjustment there and drive his knee into the abdomen of Steamboat. And now he returns those body slams in kind. Drops that elbow right on his chest. Lateral press. And Steamboat able to get a shoulder up before three. Great wrestling match.
Yeah, what a match this is. You know, it's boiling down. Who's going to make the first mistake? When tempers fly, mistakes are made.
Dustin Rhodes sets that up. Could have him waist locked. And Steamboat able to kick out. And now Steamboat hooking both legs. And he got a near fall. And as we said, it's one fall or TV time remaining. We'll keep our eye closely on the clock. Oh, man. He got the arm hook right there. Another near fall.
Oh. Quick move by Dustin Rhodes, considering his size.
Inside cradle and Rhodes. I thought he had him there. He had him locked up and Steamboat able to kick out of it. Boy, neither guy can really gain a big advantage. Rhodes, high cross body.
High cross body with a lot of weight.
Sleeper by Steamboat. I understand. Rhodes drove his head right up in the jaw of Steamboat. We've got approximately 1 minute of wrestling time left. Rhodes going for the cover. He wants to win it right here. And the United States heavyweight champion, one count away.
We got 1 minute left, but it's only in 3 seconds. We need... Oh!
Steamboat again going for the pinning combination. Rhodes with a big knee lift there. Stagger Steamboat. It takes him down with a clothesline. Lateral press by the U.S. champion. And Steamboat able to kick out. We're witnessing a great wrestling match for the United States heavyweight title. He's going to be the Bulldog.
Oh, too much time on the part of Rhodes. Steamboat felt that one.
We're just about out of wrestling time, ladies and gentlemen. And there's the bell. That's all of our wrestling time. This one is over. The time limit has expired. But these spirit athletes still want to hook it up.